I felt that that was just like the lack of integrity to allow something that's not true to let it be perpetuated.
I'm sorry you feel that way, but I had no control over that at all. I can't control what people say. People say a lot of stuff. I have no control over that.
There's things that we don't have control over, but some of the stuff that we actually say, such as,
okay,
y'all started dating before we were divorced. People feel like you're saying that as though I was the person that caused the divorce. Some of the implications that were made allowed people to run off with a narrative that just wasn't true.
Currently, I don't have a relationship with Kimmy.
Well, there you have it.
You're free to,
if you came. I've always felt like he's never really cared for me.
But in the beginning, things were sketchy. The way you met Maurice, it felt in the beginning as using me till you get a line had been crossed. We were going through whatever we were going through. I don't know what Maurice told you, but we weren't divorced yet. We weren't divorced yet.
Us meeting as friends is a completely different time frame than us actually starting to date. We didn't date it until y'all were wholly divorced.
Them groupie hopes, lie to me, using me till you get what you want.
Okay, great. That's what it is, you know.
And then I was kind of cute. I trolled him a little bit on social media. Had a couple lunches, and then I guess that's all.
With that lady husband.
You know, we done had this conversation a long time.
I really don't know how I am responsible for that.
At the end of the day, Maurice's biggest concern was Monster. Period. Maurice didn't want to do anything that was gonna harm Monster. Like if he saw the show as he grew up or later in life. Monster was a big concern for me too, but I also have a child that I don't want to think. My mom did what?
I know it sounds bad. No, you don't want to hear it, but.
Love marriage Huntsville band Slam Maurice were demanding intimacy while Kimmy goes through chemotherapy. Kimmy, what is your response to the backlash that Maurice has been getting?
When I actually did see it, I told him. The words that you chose were.
To me, it wasn't protecting me.
I mean, it was crass and, you know, non-protecting, disrespectful. A lot of those comments were at one point. I had made up in my head 7 days was the limit. Like, I would never make my husband go more than 7 days. We went about 2 weeks, and I was like, So it was my choice because I know that that's fulfilling for both of us. It's fulfilling for both of us. Like, at the end of the day, he's not the only one missing out. I'm missing out because I don't have the same climax. I don't have the same arousal. You know what I'm saying? So I've never had that conversation based on the fact that I thought he was going to leave. I know I love my husband and that is a big part of our world. I don't physically hurt. It doesn't hurt me to have sex. It doesn't do that whatsoever. It was just the arousal of the moment in the climax that is very different for me. So I'm just not getting the same fulfillment out of the sexual activity. I had to take a lot of heat for something I did not do. And my son had to see that. My son had to see it so that we could protect your son. I made my best effort not to like belabor the point. I felt like I took a ding for the whole group so that we could keep everybody safe. But Kimmy.
He said, yeah, Maurice, do you think it was selfish for you to force your wife to suffer through it while she was fighting for her life? Your words.
Your words. Now, those are my words. And I'm gonna own the words that I say. I didn't have knowledge of her suffering. I didn't have knowledge of her rolling over and giving to me when she didn't want to, right? Or didn't feel the need to. This is the thing. You surprised the hell out of me on television. Talking about, you know what? I'm not getting it. I'm faking it. Like, listen, it's on national TV. So I'm like, oh, really? So you're faking it. this whole time I'm thinking that you're doing it. And it puts everything into context when you watch the television show and then you actually see the interview, because for me to find out that she's faking it, and then for me to analyze the situation and say, it's admirable for her to do this, because number one, most people that do things for you let you know that they're doing it for you. They don't let you find out later on, oh wow, you were actually hurting, or you were going through something and you were sharing that, and you were doing it for me. So of course I would change my words and give better context than any type of interview. However, what you want, I still play with that.
Okay. I mean, I hear you and I understand what you're saying. I didn't even know you had that feeling. I mean, how would I know how you feel about that if we never had the discussion? In order
you
to
didn't correct, know they were calling me a side chick? Because
I didn't know that you felt that I was obligated for that. For you, if that makes sense. Yeah, you know? And one thing I can honestly say is,
you know, growth within myself brought me to a lot of enlightenment on a lot of different things. You know, not just this particular situation, but a lot of different things. Nobody's perfect, you know? We go through things in life and it can have a different effect on different people. So you feel that I should have said something differently?
For the record, I never said Kimmy was a side chick. That makes everybody happy. Baby.
Well, I thought the conversation went well, quite frankly. It's one of those apologies that, like, if I offended you, I'm sorry, or if I couldn't do this, I'm sorry. Just close. But, you know, it's as good as we're going to get today. We're making small strides to a better place. It may not be the place that you think or you think or you think we should be, but,
And I gotta say this, as the woman here, I feel like your wife is protecting you more than you're protecting her. I can't imagine going through what she's going through, you saying that, and then me asking you twice if you would rephrase it, and you said, yeah, but you really haven't. It seems like it's more about you than her, still.
We're talking about this because I've already said something, right? There's no taking it back. There's no swindling, leaving that veil. That veil's broken. That's why we're here. In the future, what I will do is I'm going to make sure that my wife was protected. I don't feel any different about the situation.
Ain't no stopping us. Yeah, ain't no stopping us. We keep it moving all day, all night. Yeah, ain't no stopping us. We keep it moving all day, all night.